Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about a brief introduction about Bluetooth technology. Then we are also going to talk about the various standards used by Bluetooth technology and architecture of Bluetooth technology. So let's begin with the topic. Bluetooth is considered as one of the standard in wireless PAN network. The wireless PAN network consists of an area which covers a range of 10 meter and maximum range up to 100 meters. So in order to form a network in a very short coverage area, the Bluetooth devices can be used. A Bluetooth device can provide end-to-end connectivity, that means point-to-point connectivity between the devices without having a line of sight requirement. Now let's understand the brief introduction and history about the Bluetooth technology. Now we know that Bluetooth is considered as a considerable buzz in the telecommunication market in few past years. The Bluetooth is named after 10th century Viking king known for his success in united Denmark and Norway during his rule around 1960 AD. So this is what's about history of Bluetooth technology, how the name Bluetooth comes into the picture, and that is because of the Viking king who rules Denmark and the Norway in 1960 AD. Now basically Bluetooth is low cost short range radio communication standard, and it is developed or it is originated by Ericsson in 1994. After four years, in 1998 or in 1996, Ericsson get join other companies and they form a group that is called as SIG for development of Bluetooth. So the engineers find the need for wireless transmission technology that will be cheap, robust, flexible, and consumes less power. So in order to fulfill this requirement, that is low cost, cheap, then less power consumption, the engineers are developing a technology that is nothing but Bluetooth. The Bluetooth was chosen to serve the baseline of IEEE 802.15.1 standard for wireless PAN, which can support both synchronous traffic such as voice and asynchronous data communication. So there are three basic wireless standards. The first is nothing but IRDA, second is Bluetooth, and third is IEEE 802.11. In 1994, when Ericsson developed Bluetooth technology, after that, the IEEE 802.15 standard considered Bluetooth as a foundation for developing a standard called as IEEE 802.15.1 standard. In case of Bluetooth, it provides a flexibility to the user, it provides a short range to the user, as well as it provides high data transmission rate, which varies from 2 Mbps to several Mbps. Now, the Bluetooth communication or the Bluetooth technology provides communication or transfer of both, that means synchronous voice signal as well as asynchronous data signal. This foundation of Bluetooth is used by IEEE 802.15 for developing its standard. Now let's find out the various applications of Bluetooth technology. So the first application is consumer electronics. The wireless PC peripherals, smart house, wireless PC peripherals, smart house integration, etc. In this case, we can use Bluetooth devices. For example, in case of AC, which is Bluetooth enabled, in which we can use Bluetooth technology for setting the temperature of the Bluetooth. Then second one application is nothing but games. The various controllers of the game, then the virtual reality and iPods, all these things uses Bluetooth for communication purpose. Next is nothing but the professional application, where pagers, PDA, cell phones, desktop, then automobiles, they are enabled by Bluetooth device. Then the shipping level, travel and hotels can also use the Bluetooth technology. Then industry, in industry it is used for the delivery purpose, that means for scanning purpose we can use the Bluetooth device, or for assembly line or for inspection purpose the Bluetooth technology can be used. The next is nothing but the sports training. The various health sensors can be used and various monitor tracking can be used in order to have a communication between the device and the Bluetooth connector. Or by using the health sensor, it is possible to capture the data of the vital parameters like blood pressure, heart rate, and then we can transmit that data by using a Bluetooth enabled device to a central location or any computer which is connected to it. Then in case of military application, it is used for the maintenance purpose, or it is used for monitoring the various activities of the soldiers. Now let's find out the technical details about the Bluetooth technology. the Bluetooth specification. In this topic, we are talking about version 1.1 of Bluetooth. So the Bluetooth specification describes radio device designed to operate over the very short range, and the typical range covered by Bluetooth device or the Bluetooth technology is minimum of 10 meter and maximum it is up to 100 meter or more than that, based on which version we are using. So the radio link is capable of voice and data transmission with the maximum capacity of the 720 kbps per channel with nominal throughput of 1 mbps. So depending upon which version of Bluetooth we are using, the data rate of Bluetooth varies from 720 kbps up to 1 mbps. And also the range is get changed, the coverage area is get changed from 10 meter to several meters or up to 100 meters. So 10 to 100 meter is a typical range depending upon what version and depending upon which device we are using, the range and the throughput is get vary. Then the frequency band used by the Bluetooth is nothing but the unlicensed frequency band that is called as 2.4 to 2.48 gigahertz IMS band, and they uses frequency hopping spectrum, that is FHSS, as a modulation technique. And they use full duplex signal at up to 1600 hops per second. So as the frequency is unlicensed one, anyone can use it without having the special permission or without having the special license. But because of this, it is possible that the interference from other signal can occur during the operation, because many of the household equipment, for example, cordless phone, then microwave oven also operates at the same frequency. So the one drawback of operating on this frequency, that is one drawback of operating on the unlicensed frequency, is nothing but interference from other equipment. Now moving towards the various specifications of Bluetooth, the Bluetooth specification is get classified into two types. First one is called as core specification and second is called as profile specification. So let's find out what do you mean by core specification is. This portion specifies component like radio baseband, that means access medium, link manager, service discovery protocol, transport layer, and interoperability with the different communication protocol. Whereas profile portion basically covers the protocol and procedure required for different types of Bluetooth application. So depending upon the profile specification, the different applications get developed by using the Bluetooth technology. Now, whenever the pair or a small group of Bluetooth device comes within a radio range of each other, they can form a ad hoc network without requiring any infrastructure. So basically, the Bluetooth consists of decentralized architecture where no central controller is present for maintaining or for administrating the network performance. Any device which comes in the range of the Bluetooth network can join or leave the network at any time, and therefore there is no proper structural architecture present for Bluetooth network. Devices are added or removed from the network dynamically, and they can connect or disconnect from the existing network at will and without interruption to other participants. As just discussed, any of the Bluetooth device can join the network or any of the Bluetooth device can leave the network, and that will not affect the performance of the other network devices or performance of the entire network. It depends upon the will of that particular device whether they want to join or whether they want to leave the network. Because of the decentralized architecture, this is possible. In Bluetooth, the device taking the initiative to start the communication to other devices is assumed to form a role of master, while the other receptionist becomes a slave. So Bluetooth basically operates on the master-slave architecture, or it basically uses master-slave method, in which the transmitter, or we can say, or the device which initiate or originate the communication is acts as a master, and the devices which are connected to it, or the receiving end, is called as slave. The basic architectural unit of the Bluetooth is Piconet. That Piconet is the basic form of Piconet is when two or more than two devices communicate with each other by using a Bluetooth technology, then they form a Piconet. So if we consider two PCs or two devices are communicating with each other, then the one is called as master and another is called as slave. In short, the transmitter is acts as a master and the receiver is acts as a slave, and that forms a basic Piconet in Bluetooth technology. So the device, when two devices communicate with each other, one master device and up to seven active slave devices can be connected to each other. We can communicate with each other only through their master. So one Piconet consists of one master, and to that one master, seven other slaves are connected. When the slaves want to communicate with each other, they cannot communicate directly with each other. They require to take the help from master, and then only they perform communication with the other slave. Now here figure shows the diagram of Bluetooth PicoNet, where S1 to S7 devices are connected to M1. So M1 is here acts as a master, and S1, S2, S3, S4, S5, S6 and S7 acts as a slave. And when the, for example, here if slave S6 wants to perform a communication with slave S4, then they cannot perform communication directly, as there is no direct link present between them. The S6 requires to communicate with the master first, and then master will perform a communication between S4 and S6. So this is how the PicoNet works. Maximum devices that can be connected to one PicoNet is up to 7 slaves and 1 master. So each and every Bluetooth device is exactly the same except for 48-bit device identifier, which is called as BD_ADDR. So all the Bluetooth devices operates in the same manner. There is only one exception, that the device address, which is of 48-bit, and with the help of that device address, each Bluetooth device is get differentiated from each other. Besides up to 7 active slaves, additional devices can be connected to the PicoNet in a park state, in which they listen but they do not participate. When they want to participate, they are swapped in one of the active device. It's swap out. So if any other device other than 7 active slave, if any other device wants to communicate with the PicoNet, then they can be a part of the network, but they do not involve in the process of communication. They can listen to the network, but they do not perform any transmission and reception. If they want to participate in the communication, then one active slave requires to be swapped out. They require swapping between one active slave, then only it is possible for the new device to get a part of the PicoNet or to perform communication in PicoNet. If active masters leave the PicoNet, one of the slave assume its role. So when the masters only wants to leave the network, or when masters only leave the network, then any of the slave acts as a master for that particular PicoNet. With this method, up to 255 devices can be virtually connected to the PicoNet. So actually, the communication takes place between the one master and 7 slaves, but virtually we can connect up to 255 devices. These devices can form a PicoNet, but they are not able to take a part in the communication process. Each PicoNet uses different frequency hop sequence in order to reduce the interference from nearby PicoNet. So every PicoNet uses the different techniques for frequency hop sequence so that no interference can be takes place between the neighboring PicoNets. To increase the number of devices in the network, scatternet architecture consisting of several PicoNet have been proposed. So in order to provide more coverage, or in order to cover more area, two or more than two PicoNets get connected with each other, and that forms one complete network, which is called as scatternet. So here figure of scatternet is present, in which three PicoNets together forms one scatternet. PicoNet 1, PicoNet 2 and PicoNet 3, they are get connected together to form one scatternet. So that figure shows a scatternet consists of three PicoNet. Since the scatternet span more than one single PicoNet, therefore few nodes acts as a bridge responsible for relaying packets across the PicoNet boundaries, that is B12, 13 and 23. Let's move back to the diagram. So here we can say that B12, which is a part of PicoNet 2, B13, which is a part of PicoNet 3, and B23, which is a part of PicoNet 2, and B12, which is a part of PicoNet 1. They act as a bridge so that the data transfer can be takes place between the two PicoNets. When the two PicoNets wants to communicate with each other, they communicate through B12, B23 and B13 as they act as a bridge. Now after types of specification, the Bluetooth specification defines two different types of link for data and voice application. The first link is called as synchronous connection oriented, which is also called as SCO link, and other is asynchronous connectionless, which stands for ACL link. So let's first find out what you mean by synchronous connection oriented, that is SCO link. So SEO link is a symmetric point-to-point link between the master and one slave. The SEO link is used for audio applications with a strict quality of service requirement. So it is basically used for the voice communication or for transmitting the voice data, and it is a point-to-point. That means there is only one master and one slave is present, and it is asymmetrical in nature. Now, the second method or the second type is nothing but asynchronous connectionless link, which is also indicated by ACL, and it is basically used for the distributed network, or we can say it is basically used for the packet switch, point-to-point and point-to-multipoint data traffic. The SCO is only for the point-to-point, but ACL is for point-to-point as well as for point-to-multipoint data transfer, and it is used for the packet switch type of network. The master maintains one ACL link with each active slave over which the upper layer connection can be established, and retransmission is employed only when it is necessary to ensure the data integrity. So when if the data is get hampered or data is get altered during transmission, then that will causes a data integrity to get reduced. So in order to maintain the data integrity in case of ACL, master maintain a one link, that is ACL link, with each slave, and the data transfer is takes place in this link, as well as the retransmission of the data is also performed if the data is get altered or the data is get hampered during transmission. So whenever there is a question on integrity of the data, then only the retransmission takes place in case of Bluetooth. Now, the physical link type are nothing but the two types that we have just discussed earlier, that is SCO and the ACL. The SCO, as we know that SCO is a symmetric point-to-point link, and it is a single slave and one master, one, that means a piconet which consists of single slave and single master. The master maintains SCO link by using reserve slot, as it uses a reserve slot at regular interval. It basically carries the voice information and is symmetrical in nature. The master can support up to 3 simultaneous SCO link, while slave can support 2 or 3 SCO link. The SCO packets are never retransmitted. SCO packets are used for 64 kbps speech transmission. As it is a voice transmission and it is a symmetrical type of thing, therefore it never supports retransmission, and it transmits the data at the speed of 64 kbps. Now more about ACL, that is asynchronous connectionless link. As we know, the ACL is used for point to point as well as point to multipoint connection, and therefore it is acts as a link between the master and all the slaves participating on that piconet. In the slot not reserved for SCO link, the master can establish ACL link on per slot basis to any slave, including the slave already engaged in an ACO link. That means it uses packet switch type of network. Master maintains one ACL with each and every slave. Only a single ACL link can exist. For most ACL packets, packet retransmission is applied. So ACL is basically used for the retransmission of the data whenever the data integrity gets hampered during the transmission. Now, after physical layer, move on to the logical channel. So Bluetooth having 5 different logical channels which can be used for the transfer of different types of information. So the first logical channel is nothing but the control logic or control channel LC, and link manager LM are used in the link level, while UA, UI, US channels are used to carry asynchronous, synchronous and synchronous user information. So the 5 logical channels are nothing but LC, which stands for control channel, LM, which stands for link manager, then UA, which stands for asynchronous user information, UI, which stands for synchronous user information, US stands for synchronous user information. So these are the 5 logical channels used for carrying the different types of user information on Bluetooth network. Now, as we know that many wireless devices can be connected by using a Bluetooth technology, therefore the device addressing plays an important role. So let's discuss something about device addressing. So there are 4 possible ways by using we can address the Bluetooth device, and they are BD, ADDR, second one is AM, ADDR, third is PM, ADDR, and fourth is AR, ADDR. So let's discuss these addressing in detail. So first is Bluetooth device address, which is indicated by BD_ADDR. So each Bluetooth transceiver having a unique address, which is a 48-bit, that is called as 48-bit device address, that is nothing but Bluetooth device address. It is divided into 24-bit lap field, then 16-bit nap field, and 8-bit UPA field. So this is how the 48-bit is get divided. Then the second type of address is nothing but active member address, and it is represented by AM_ADDR. So it is basically a 3-bit number, and it is valid only as long as the slave is active on the channel. It is also sometimes called as MAC address of the Bluetooth unit. The next address is nothing but park member address, and it is represented by PM_ADDR. It is 8-bit address. That address separates the park slaves. The PM address is only valid as long as the slave is park. That means as the 7 devices are already connected in one piconet to one master, and if the 8th device wants to part of that network, then that device can only act as a part of that network but not actually performs the communication, and that 8th device is called as park member of the piconet. The next one is the access request address, which is represented by AR_ADDR. It is used by the park slave to determine the slave to master half slot in the access window. It is allowed to send access request message in. It is only valid as long as the slave is park, and it is not necessarily unique. It may be a same for other devices also. Now next, let's have a discussion about the Bluetooth packet types. So all the data on the piconet is transferred in the form of packets. So the different packets of the Bluetooth are 13 different packets are defined for a Bluetooth. All higher layers uses this packet to compose higher level units. And the packets are ID, null, pole, FHS, that is frequency hop spectrum, DM1. These packages are defined for both SCO as well as ACL link. That means synchronous connection oriented link and asynchronous connection list link. Then DH1, auxiliary 1, DM3, DH3, DM5, DH5 are defined for ACL link only. And HV1, HV2, HV3, DV are defined for SOC link. So total there are 13 packets type used by Bluetooth technology. Now these 13 packets having one proper format, and that is called as packet format. So each packet consists of three entities. Figure shows the packet format of the Bluetooth. It consists of access code, which is 68 or 72 bits. So first of all, access code is present, then the header, which is having 54 bits, and then payload is present, which varies from 0 to 2745 bits. So these three fields are the main part of the Bluetooth packets. So let's understand what this packet or what this field performs. So first is nothing but the access code. Let's move back to the diagram. So the access code is of 68 or 72 bits. So basically access code is used for time synchronization, it is used for offset compensation, and it is used for paging and inquiry functions. So these three functions are performed by access code, and there are three different types of access code, and they are channel access code, that is CAC, second is device access code, that is DAC, and third is inquiry access code, that is IAC. Now the channel access code, that is CAC, is basically used to identify the unique piconet, while the DAC is used for paging and its response, IAC is used for the inquiry purpose. So if we want to find out the address or if we want to find out the piconet, then we require to use the CAC. If we want the information about paging and if we want the information about the response, then the DAC is used, and for inquiry purpose, IAC is used. Then the second field present in the packet format or the frame format of Bluetooth is nothing but header, which is of 54 bit. So it contains information for the packet acknowledgement, then packet numbering for out of order packet recording, then it is also used for the flow control purpose, then it is used for storing the slave address, and it is used for error correction and error detection purpose. Next is nothing but payload, which varies from 0 to 2740 bits depending upon what type of data it is transmitting. The payload can contain either voice field, or it can contain data, or it can contain both voice as well as data. It has a data field. The payload will also contain the payload header. Next is nothing but the channel control, and the channel control having the controller states. The controller state is basically the Bluetooth controller operates in two major states. First is standby state and second is connection state. There are seven sub states which are used to add slave to or to make a connection in PicoNet. The seven sub states used in the Bluetooth are used are nothing but page scan, inquiry scan, then master response, slave response and inquiry response. So these seven sub states are used for making connection or for originating the connection in Bluetooth. Now let's understand how the connection is get set up in case of Bluetooth, or that means inquiry and paging happen in Bluetooth. So normally a connection between two devices occurs as follows. If nothing is known about the remote device, both the inquiry one and page two procedure have to be followed. If some details are known about the remote device, only page procedure is need to be followed. So depending upon what is known, based on that the page or inquiry is get formed. If nothing known about the user or nothing known about the device, then both inquiry as well as page procedure required to followed by the device. If some details about the device are known, then only paging procedure is required to be followed. So the step one is the inquiry procedure enables the device to discover which device are in the range and determine the address and clocks for that device, so that the synchronization can be takes place with the help of clock. And in first step, the inquiry procedure. In the inquiry procedure, first of all, the device which are present in the range are get finding out, and then the address of the device is get obtained. So the inquiry procedure involves unit, that means source, sending out inquiry packets and then receives the inquiry reply. That is considered as a first step. Then in the inquiry process, the second step is the unit which receives the inquiry request or inquiry packet will hopefully be in the inquiry scan state to receive the inquiry packets. If it is in the inquiry scan state, then only it receives the inquiry packet. Then the third step is the destination will then enter the inquiry response state and send the inquiry reply to the source. So after entering into the inquiry state, the responses get sent from the device. That response is called as inquiry response to the source. After inquiry processes get completed, the next is nothing but connection is get established by using the paging process. Now in the paging process, actual connection is get established. The paging process typically follow the inquiry process only. First of all, it will send a request. Only the Bluetooth device address is required for setting the connection. So in the inquiry process only, we obtain the Bluetooth address or Bluetooth device address. So that address is now help for establishing the connection. Knowledge about the clock will accelerate the setup process. So in the inquiry process, we find out the devices which are present in the range, we find out the address of the Bluetooth device, and we find out the clock information about that Bluetooth device. So these three information helps to establish the connection in paging state. So that clock information is basically required for the synchronization purpose. The unit that establish a connection will carry out a page procedure and automatically be a master of the connection. So the transmitter, usually the person or the node which originates the communication, is called as master. So the process of paging is basically a device pages another device, that means the source pages destination, which is called as page state. Then the second step is the destination receives the page, which is called as page scan state. The third step is nothing but the destination send a reply to the source, which is called as that means the slave now entered into the response state, that is step one. Then the source now send FHS packet to a destination, that means the master response state. The destination now send its reply, that means a second reply to the slave, and that is called as slave response state. The next step is nothing but the destination and the source then switch to a source channel parameters. That means here the two steps get happen. First step is master response state and second is nothing but slave response state. So these steps are followed by the Bluetooth device in order to set up a connection by using a paging process. So these steps are required to be followed by the Bluetooth devices in order to set up the connection between the Bluetooth devices. The connection state starts with poll packets sent by the master to verify that the slave has switched to the master's timing and channel frequency hopping. When the synchronization takes place between the receiver, that means the slave and master, that means when the slave switched to the master's timing and master's channel frequency hopping, then only the master send a poll packet so that the connection or the data transfer is get begin or the connection is get actually established between the source and destination. The slave can respond with any type of packet. So to that poll signal, the slave can be responded. That means the slave can send an acknowledgement by using any form of packet. Now, after establishing a connection, the next thing comes into the picture is nothing but the connection mode. The Bluetooth device is in connection state, can be in any of the mode. It may be in active, hold, sniff or park mode. So after even the connection is get established, the Bluetooth can be entered in any of the mode, and that mode is called as connection mode. So the four different types of mode are active mode, hold mode, sniff mode and park mode. So let's discuss what do you mean by active mode is. In active mode, the Bluetooth unit actively participate on the channel. As its name indicate, it performs the device communication. The master schedules the transmission based on the traffic demands to or from the different slaves. So on the basis of what type of data and on the basis of traffic to that particular device or to that particular slave, based on that, the master decide the transmission. In addition to the regular transmission to keep the slave synchronized to the channel, the active slave listen to the master to slave slot for packets. If active slave is not addressed, it may sleep until next new master transmission. So if the packet or if this traffic is not intended to that particular active slave, then it enters into the sleep mode. The next is nothing but sniff mode. Now devices synchronized to a piconet can enter into the power saving mode in which device activity is get lowered. So whenever the device entered into the power saving mode, the device activity get lowered or it performs a less activity so that it can consume less power and save more powers. In the sniff mode, the slave devices listen to the piconet at the reduced rate and thus reducing its duty cycle. So the sniff mode or the sleep interval is basically depending upon in which application we are using the Bluetooth technology, and it is a programmable by the user. It has the highest duty cycle, least power efficient of all three power saving mode, that is sniff, hold and park. So out of these three, the sniff mode having the highest duty cycle, that means it is least power efficient. Next is nothing but the hold mode. The devices synchronized to a piconet can enter into the power saving mode, which in which the device activity is get lowered. The master unit can put slave mode on the hold when only an inter timer is running. So similar to sniff mode, here also in hold mode also the device activity is get reduced, and the slave unit can also demand to put it in the hold mode. Either the master put the device or the slave into the hold mode, or slave itself can demand for putting into the hold mode. The data transfer restarts instantly when the unit transition out from hold mode. So as soon as the slave device comes out of the hold mode, it performs the data transfer. It has intermediate duty cycle, medium power efficient for three power saving mode. So the least power efficient is nothing but the sniff mode. Then the medium or moderate power efficient is nothing but the hold mode, because in hold mode also the device activity is get reduced for consuming the or for saving the power. The next mode is nothing but the park mode. Now in the park mode, the device is still synchronized to the piconet but does not participate in the traffic. Park devices has given their MAC address and occasionally listen to the traffic of the master and resynchronize and check on the broadcast message. It has the lowest duty cycle of the all three power mode. So in park mode, the device is still synchronized with the master, device is still synchronized with the piconet, but it not actually participate in the traffic. Or else we can say that if the piconet consists of 7 slaves, and if the 8th device wants to be a part of the piconet, then it can be in the park state. It is synchronized with the piconet, but it do not participate in the data transmission. The park device having an address which is called as AM address, and it occasionally listen to the traffic present on the network and resynchronize analyze it and check with the broadcast message. If it wants to participate into the communication, then it requires to swap with one of the active slave. Then only it is possible to be a part of the network, or it is possible to take part in the actual communication going on between master and slave. Now, out of the three mode, that is sniff, hold and park mode, this mode having the lowest duty cycle. So in this mode also the activity of the device is get lowered because for the power saving. So these are the four connection modes of the Bluetooth device after forming a connection between the two Bluetooth device. So this is what about the Bluetooth technology, in which we have covered the various technical specifications about the Bluetooth, history of Bluetooth, various applications of Bluetooth, along with that the connection mode, packet format and the various layers of the Bluetooth. As the need of wireless communication is increasing, the development in the Bluetooth technology is moving in a rapid growth, and therefore more and more applications can be involved by using the Bluetooth technology. So I hope you understand this topic of Bluetooth technology. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.